In this iPage review, I'm going to show you everything that you need to know about iPage before deciding if they are the right hosting provider for you. In this comprehensive review, I will start by breaking down the pricing structure and show you how to get the best deal currently available. Next, I will guide you through the entire sign-up process and judge how easy their platform is to use. I will then grade their performance based on page load speed and uptime from the iPage plan that I purchased. And lastly, I will provide you with the pros and cons and my honest recommendations on if or who should get iPage. At the end of this video, I will give you a very special offer if you decide to pick up iPage through my link below. I will give you my six-figure blogger course for free as a way of saying thank you for supporting my channel. In this course, I show you how to set up your WordPress website the right way, how to adjust and tweak settings for optimal website performance, and how to start driving traffic and make money from your site. Now let's get straight into this review. Pricing options. Click on the link in the description or type this into your browser. It will take you to my special iPage discount page, where you will get the best discount iPage is currently offering. I will be looking at iPage's standard web hosting plan in this review. Now you can see here, iPage's plan is very simple. There is just one plan only. It's called the Go plan, and it costs you only $1.99 per month. And in general, it's really, really cheap as you're getting unlimited websites for this plan, where normally hosting providers only give you one website on their cheapest plan, which is around $2 to $3. But iPage is giving you unlimited websites, so that's a good start. Some of the things that I think iPage is lacking in their plan is they don't provide you with free daily automatic backup, which is something I expect every hosting provider to give for free, as it is a standard feature nowadays. The second thing I believe they're missing is the custom cache plugin to improve the speed performance of your website. This is also missing. But for this price and unlimited websites, you can't complain too much. Now, the next thing to talk about is the billing period. iPage offers 12 months, 24 months, and 36 month plans. So you can see here, the longer you buy, the cheaper it gets, as it's only $1.99 per month if you purchase it for 3 years, but it's going to go up to $2.99 per month if you only purchase it for 1 year. So what I always recommend you do, and what I always do myself, is I purchase the longest plan possible, as this will save you the most money, because when it comes time to renew, it's going to be at full price, so you'll lose money there. And iPage has a 30-day money-back guarantee. So I'm not saying that iPage is the right hosting provider for you yet. We still got to test them out with their speed and performance. But for your first 30 days, you may as well buy it for 3 years. So now I would choose their Go plan for this tutorial to test them out. The next thing regarding pricing is iPage's domain costs. It is very expensive and I don't think you should purchase it from here. Even though you get the free domain name for the first year, it's going to cost you $17.99 per year for renewal after that, plus another $9.99 for domain privacy. So that's about $28 in total. Whereas specialist domain companies like Namecheap, which I use myself, will only set you back $13 per year. So that's less than half price of iPage. So the overall pricing score I would give iPage is an 8 out of 10. They are a cheap hosting provider, starting at just $1.99 per month for multiple websites. They do provide you with enough basic features to get started. However, I didn't like the fact that they charge so much for the domain name, but at least they offer you 1 year for free, so that's not too bad. I did take one mark off them, as they don't offer automatic daily backups on all their plan for free. I believe this feature is very important and should come as standard on all hosting plan nowadays, instead of paying a dollar per month extra for it, like with iPage. I also took another mark off them for not having a custom caching plugin like A2 Hosting or SiteGround does. This feature would further increase the speed performance of your website, but is missing with iPage here. This would not matter though if their overall speed is still high, but there's only one way to find out, and that is to test it. And I will do just that later on in this video. So keep watching to find out how well they perform here. After purchase setup and ease of use. Right away from their homepage, you can see it looks very easy to navigate with their custom interface compared to the cPanel that a lot of other hosting providers use. The design is also very clean and simple looking here, where on the left side of the panel are all the different things that you can do, like access your WordPress website or access your email account and even your security and domain and name servers. Now let's see how easy it is to install and create our WordPress website. And to do that, from our dashboard, we click on WordPress, click on Get Started, Use Existing Plan, type in your site title, put in your email, username and password. Make sure you don't use admin in your username, as this will make it easier for hackers to get into your website. And you can see the WordPress installation process was very simple. I believe it's more intuitive than on the cPanel. And how about installing an SSL certificate? All you have to do is click this one button. Let's encrypt, turn that on, and that's it. Now your SSL certificate is activated. It's that simple. But just a quick note to be careful of on iPage and the upsell is if you click on SSL certificate here, this will take you to the paid option where they try and make you pay $3 per month for the SSL certificate. So just so you're aware, don't go this option. The next thing I'll show you is creating an email account. So this one I didn't like so much because the top two options under email management is G Suite and Microsoft 365, which are paid options. They've hidden the standard options down below. But once you've found it, it's very easy to create your email account. You just click on the plus button, fill out your name and password, and now just click on create mailbox. And that's it. Very straightforward and easy to do. Overall, I would score iPage an 8 out of 10 for setup and ease of use. I really like that they have a super clean looking interface with custom shortcut buttons to install and create things instead of having to go to cPanel all the time. I did take 2 marks away from them because they don't guide you well when installing your SSL certificates or creating your email accounts. They tend to mislead you into their upsell a bit too much. Speed and uptime performance tests. So after I have installed the basic WordPress site, I went ahead and tested out the speed of the bare bones website using GT metrics. And the result is 2.4 seconds. This is not really a great start for iPage. The speed is very slow right out of the gate. I always expect bare bone websites to be around the 1 second mark. So iPage is a fair way off here. But let's give them the benefit of the doubt here and laser in more on the next test. So now I will take it a step further and add some design elements to it to increase the page size. And don't worry, if you are overwhelmed looking at this, my course that I will provide you for supporting the channel will guide you through this step by step. I'm also going to install some free plugins to speed up the website. WP Fastest Cache, which is for the speed optimization, and Short Pixel, which is for image optimization. And lastly, I will install the free Cloudflare app, which will also increase the website performance with their CDN for free. This will make it more comparable to what you would do in real life. Just a quick note here, after halfway through installing my Astra theme, my iPage WordPress account froze. This ended up being due to the limit that was placed on my account from iPage. I must say, it's really disappointing as this is the first time that something like this has ever happened to me. They did increase the storage for me, but told me that if it exceeds again, then they recommended me to upgrade. So I was definitely not happy with that, as I've only installed one theme on one website, and that is it. But they promise an unlimited number of websites. This is now what the new website layout with all the new plugins look like. And the speed is now 3.5 seconds, which is just way too slow compared to the top performing hosting providers in my tests. And they also failed Google's recommended site load speed of 3 seconds also. Now I have been monitoring the stability performance of iPage with Uptime Robot and can report that their uptime for the last 30 days is a perfect 100%. In fact, they have not had any downtime for over 57 days in a row, which is very impressive. Overall, I would rate iPage's speed and uptime performance a 6 out of 10. Their speed just wasn't fast enough, so I had to deduct a lot of points there. Other shared hosting providers can give you speed performance twice as fast as iPage. On the positive side though, they are a very reliable host and their uptime was perfect, so I cannot fault them on that part. Here's a quick question for you. What is your current page load speed and who is your web hosting provider? Let me know in the comments section below. Support. iPage provides 24/7 customer support through email, live chat, and phone calls. I would test them out by asking them these three different questions on live chat. 1. I would tell them that I have been infected by a virus on my website and ask for their help. 2. I ask them a quick question about their domain name renewal costs. And 3. I ask them if they could do me a favor and install an SSL certificate and Cloudflare for me, as I am a complete newbie and have no idea how to do this. Here are the results. 1. I wasn't really happy with their service here. They tried not to help me scan my website for malware, as I had to ask them 3 times, and then they were not able to help me resolve it on live chat. They had to instead create a support ticket, which took hours to respond with a report in the end. They also tried to upsell me at the end of the conversation, which was also very disappointing. 2. This was done very well, and they answered all my questions about domain name costs in one go clearly, and everything took less than 5 minutes. And 3. The support staff was willing to help me to a certain extent. They did try a few times for me to contact either Namecheap or Cloudflare instead of just helping me and guiding me. Also, they were confused and told me to install extra SSL plugins at the end, which was not required on my brand new website. They didn't do a good job on this one. With regards to their response time, I contacted them at 3 different times of the day to make sure I get an overall average and not just a biased fast response time during their off-peak hours. So the 3 times were 5 seconds, 2 seconds, and 1 second. The average of those 3 times turns out to be 3 second wait, which is definitely the fastest out of all hosting providers I have tested out so far. Amazing response time here. Overall, I would have to score iPage's support a 5 out of 10. Support overall was average. Their support staff's knowledge and willingness to help was pretty bad. They tried to upsell me at the end of a conversation too, which was really not good. They should be spending time trying to help me instead of selling to me. The only reason I still gave them a pass mark overall was because their response time was the fastest I have ever tested. At an average of 3 seconds, they are a second to none. Do you like the level of detail I'm providing in my review so far? If so, just make sure to let me know by liking my video and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on more quality content I release every single week. Features, cons. So let me first start off with the cons. 1. The biggest issue I have with iPage is their website speed. It is fairly slow compared to other hosting providers in the same budget category. At 3.5 second load speed, it is just too slow for me to be viable, especially when its best competitors are loading pages almost twice as fast as this. 2. They only have 2 server locations, which are both located in the United States. So for anyone with their main source of traffic coming from somewhere else, the website speed will be slower and so may not be suitable for you. 3. Not having free daily automatic backup is just not good enough nowadays. Every decent hosting provider is expected to have this feature, plain and simple. You can't underestimate how critical this feature is for your website. 4. Their support staff's technical knowledge was lacking and were not able to provide the level of service compared to other hosting providers. And the last con, number 5, isn't a big deal for some, but they just annoyed me a bit with always trying to upsell, making it hard to find free options like when setting up an email address or getting upsold on during live chat support. Pros. The first pro that stands out to me is iPage's perfect 100% uptime. Even though they are not a fast hosting provider, at least they make up for it a bit by being reliable. Of course, ideally you want both, but there's no point having blazing fast speeds if your site is always down. The second big pro is an intuitive backend system, which I believe is much easier to navigate and use than cPanel. This may not be a big deal for someone who has been building websites for a while, but it is a big plus for beginners just starting out. And the last pro is their price. It is really cheap for unlimited websites. However, they also had a hidden storage limit, which I encountered when only halfway through setting up my first website. Their unlimited website advertisement is far from the truth, and may mean it is not actually cheap, but I will leave this one up to you to decide. This is just a quick note regarding my bonus offer to you. If you decide to pick up iPage through my link, just send me your receipt to bonus@dotcomdollar.com and I'll send you back access to my bonus course. Recommendation. Overall, I have given iPage an average score of 6.5 out of 10. They are a reliable hosting provider with a cheap price and have an easy to navigate backend, but it really ends there. Their speed is too slow and their support team is not good enough for me to recommend for both beginners and intermediates due to those 2 points. There are much better options out there for you in a similar price range that is a lot faster. Now, I think picking the right hosting provider is such a crucial step for your business. So if after watching my review, you think iPage is not the right hosting provider for you, then I recommend you check out this hosting provider, which is the alternative that I recommend to all my viewers. But if you're happy with iPage, that's not a problem, no judging here. But I recommend you go to this next video. So I'll see you in one of those next two videos now.